bye-bye, iOS 19. We literally never knew you. Come make the jump with me from iOS 18 to iOS 26 in Apple's first software redesign in over a decade. Hey friends, I'm Tayshia Custody, and you may very well be living under a rock if you haven't heard about Apple's software rebrand that's going to leave our iPhones with a different look and feel. But don't worry, in this video, I'm sharing what this rebrand means for you in terms of that look and feel, and I'm diving into what to expect from iOS 26. Let's go! Let's start with the naming convention. Why did Apple jump from iOS 18 to iOS 26? From now on, all of Apple's operating systems, so think iPadOS, iOS, watchOS, macOS, etc., will be named for the year after their release. So think this year was WWDC 2025, they've announced iOS 26. Next year, they'll announce 27. So Apple said they're doing this to really create some continuity between all of the OS models. So they're all basically named the same thing. Think of it like it's really similar to what car manufacturers do when they release a model. And don't worry, macOS will still continue its naming traditions where they name it after somewhere in California. So macOS 26 will be Tahoe. Now that we understand the naming convention for iOS 26, let's jump into the words that are on everybody's lips. Liquid glass. Everyone keeps talking about it, but what is liquid glass and what does it mean for you? Liquid glass is Apple's name for the all-new, somewhat transparent glass-like redesign. With this redesign, your iPhone menus are going to have a more kind of frosted glass-like dynamic appearance with specular highlights. You will notice some sleeker, rounder edges to match the bezel and almost this kind of depth of feel with it. And that explains the glass part of the name, but what about liquid? Well, menus and buttons respond in real time to your content and input. Some even open up into new group menus. This liquid glass redesign works in both light and dark mode, but Apple also announced an all-new clear mode, which is like a semi-transparent mode. Now, I don't think I'd ever use that because it's hard enough for me to navigate and find my apps, and if everything looks the same, it's no bueno for me. But tell me, would you use this all-new clear mode? No judgment. All right, let's look at the newly updated adaptive lock screens because there's some cool stuff going on here. Wallpapers are more dynamic with iOS 26. The time fluidly adapts to the available space according to the image. It will scale the weight, width, and height of each lock screen photo. It will also keep the best part of the photo in view as new information and notifications keep happening. There's also a 3D effect that you can enable for your lock screen. Moving on to camera controls and an update to the Photos app, because there was something we had that they took away that they're bringing back. When in the camera app on iOS 26, you'll be able to quickly choose between shooting video or taking still photos. And other modes are a swipe away along the bottom or a swipe up for additional settings. Now, some Android users may be familiar with this change in navigation because, like, take a look at my Pixel here. You can see it's quite similar with that tap between modes and swipe between modes. I'm just saying. The design on iOS 26 is prettier though, if that counts for something. And all format options are available with a single tap. And rejoice, fellow iPhone users, because the Photos app has been redesigned yet again, and it's bringing back our library and collections tabs. Amen. And the 3D effect we saw on the lock screen is actually available in the Photos app for photos too. CarPlay is also getting a redesign and a couple handy updates. First, Apple's new liquid glass design is offered here as well for continuity purposes. And maybe more helpful are newly designed, less invasive on-screen controls when you get a call while you're navigating. By the way, widgets and live activities will also be available in CarPlay. And there are a couple of updates to the phone app. First, call screening is coming to iOS 26. And if this also sounds familiar to Android users, well, that's because it is. But Apple finally has a version for iOS. Call screening runs in the background and screens the call for you. Once the caller shares their name and the reason for the call, your phone will ring and then you can view the response and either pick up or ignore the call. The next phone app update is Hold Assist, and it is coming here to save you from being on hold forever. Productivity unlocked. Next time you're on hold, the phone app automatically detects hold music and asks you if you want to hold this call. When you tap hold, the music stops, but the call will stay connected. So you can just keep on using your iPhone and doing what you're doing. Once someone becomes available, your phone will ring to return you to the call. And then the person on the other end will be told that you'll be there shortly. So now in essence, they're on hold. Sweet, sweet justice. And our Lifeline messages app is getting a few updates too. First, you can now set a background in a chat for everyone to enjoy, which is really fun. There are dynamic preset backgrounds, or you can choose one of your own photos. For group chats, you're going to be able to create a poll for just about anything and have the group share preferences in a more visual manner in your chat. There will also be the much requested typing indicators for group chats as well. And spam messages are getting easier to avoid too. Unknown senders will now be placed in a designated area where you can decide to mark the number as known, ask for more info, or delete the message. Until you accept, messages from unknown senders will remain silent and won't bombard you with notifications. Thank you, Apple. Live translation is also coming, and yes, this will work across multiple apps. Live translation is going to let you translate on the fly using Apple Intelligence. So in messages, live translation will automatically translate text for you. What this looks like in FaceTime is that you will have translated live captions, which means you can chat with your family or friends across the world. You still hear each other's voices, you still see their face, but you have live translated captions in your language right on screen. Yes, please. When you are on a phone call, your translation is spoken out loud for the call recipients. As they respond, you hear a spoken translation of their voice. So similar to a lot of the Google offerings we've seen, there's really no reason to learn a new language anymore, right? Like, I don't have to learn and struggle with my French or Italian anymore, right? Right? In all seriousness, I can't wait to try this with my family in Italy and my friends in Spain. Game changer. And I hate to sound like a broken record here, but Apple has ripped something else right from the Google playbook again. They have updated visual intelligence so that you'll be able to search anything on your screen. Sound familiar? So if for some reason you don't use Google Lens or Gemini in Chrome or Google Live with Camera on iOS, this could be helpful for you on your iPhone. Visual intelligence works with any app. So if you see a social post and you want to know where to get that jacket, take a screenshot like you normally would. Now on iOS 26, at the bottom of that screenshot, you're going to have an image search option where you can find similar images on Google or other apps that you use frequently. You can also use this same technique to add an event to your calendar. iOS 26 will be available this fall of 2025. And remember, these design changes extend to macOS, watchOS, iPadOS, CarPlay, and more. And I've linked to the entire WWDC 2025 for you below if you want to learn more about changes to Wallet, Maps, and Siri, well, still being Siri. So what are you most excited about for iOS 26? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more content just like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.